Hey everyone, let's talk about the error associated with the left and right Riemann sum variations that we learned about in the last video. When we use Riemann sums to find the area under a curve, we're using rectangles to approximate the area under said curve. We specify they are approximations, which means that there's bound to be some error involved. This error can be found through two other types of Riemann sums, that being the upper Riemann sum and the lower Riemann sum. The upper Riemann sum is the sum of the area of our rectangles that optimize for overestimation of our curve's area, while the lower Riemann sum is the sum of the areas of rectangles that completely underestimate our curve's area. So, let's talk about these two Riemann sum variations a bit in more detail. Beginning with the upper Riemann sum, how do we find the maximum rectangular area, or said another way, how do we optimize to find the maximum overestimation of our area? Well, we will use the properties of the left and right Riemann sums that we learned about in our theory video. We learned that if a function is increasing between two bounds, then the right Riemann sum will maximize the overestimation. And when a function is decreasing, the left Riemann sum will optimize the overestimation of our area. This should make sense when sketched out, and you can see that here on the left. For these Riemann sums, you want to ensure that the function is monotonically increasing or decreasing. This means that the function is only trending one direction within our bounds of our numerical integration. But we'll talk more about this in our upcoming example videos. Now, in numerical methods, we want to know what our maximum possible error for a given numerical technique can be. Therefore, for this method, our maximum possible error is going to be the absolute value of our overestimation minus our underestimation. The absolutes just ensure that only our magnitude of the difference between these two values is going to be representing our error, meaning we get the correct answer if our function is both increasing or decreasing. Therefore, we could write it like so, however, with the absolute bars, it doesn't really matter. Now, let's develop an equation to check our answer using this method. Let's assume a monotonically increasing function with equal spacing for now. Let's plug in our right Riemann sum and our left Riemann sum equations for equally spaced step sizes that we found in the last video. As you can see, since we share common step size, all these terms here in the two Riemann sums are actually equivalent, and they cancel each other out. This leaves us with our step size times the function evaluated at our endpoint minus our function evaluated at our initial point. And just to reiterate, this is the maximum error we can occur using Riemann sums. It is important to note here that decreasing our step size reduces our error, which we have talked about previously. I think this is best demonstrated visually, so let's do that now. Let's imagine that we have two identical functions, one with 4 subintervals and one with 8. Drawing out our left and right Riemann sums like this, you can imagine this rectangle on the right as a summation of error incurred during each subinterval. Then, repeating this process for our higher subinterval group, our height of the rectangle does not change. However, our width is now half of what it previously was, thereby reducing our error by half. This agrees with our previous maximum error equation, as you can see they are equivalent, and how our delta x is indifferent to the signage of f of b minus f of a. I hope that this video helped your understanding of error incurred during Riemann sums. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.